I've implemented the death animation, as well as the code behind it. If you hit the other player enough times, we go into a brief slow motion as the death animation kicks in. The hit stops are also there. When a player dies, there's a bit of a hit stop and the ending slow motion. It's a combination of what I call the scheduler, which is just a callback function, plus the skipper, which skips certain fixed updates so you get the feeling of slowing down. It does not refer to a person that's in charge of a boat. Anyways, inside skipper.h, we have an std function, which is similar to a function pointer. I store a function and then call it whenever I want to. In this case, I would call it after skipping a certain number of fixed updates, giving you the illusion of the game going into slow motion. You might also notice the HP bar. There's also a bit of an animation going on with the bars. Instead of instantly decreasing to a certain percentage, it's smoothed out. One little feature which started out as a bug is you also get the smoothing in the negative direction, meaning if I restart the game and the HP is initialized at 0, the animation also kicks in as we go from 0 to 100. I like it, so I kept it. It's the ease calculator that makes it possible in either direction, and I could use this anywhere that requires some sort of a smooth motion. I'm not using Visual Studio anymore. Instead, I'm using Visual Studio Code. I was using Visual Studio way back when I was using Unity a lot. I switched because it's more modular and lightweight. Also, I might decide to have a Linux build later on. Going through CMake and GCC and JSON files and all that was very painful at first. But once you get going, it's pretty good. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, you can reach me with the links below. Thanks for watching.